Hi folks, and welcome to the channel and my review of the Disney Dream, which I've been on a transatlantic crossing now for 2 weeks. And here are some of my thoughts. You know, I've always resisted getting on a Disney cruise. I love cruising and I love Disney, so you'd think this would be my dream, but I just didn't think the two would go together. So what do I think now? Well, check out this review. By the end, you'll know how I feel about it now. Hey everyone, so I thought what better place to bring you my entertainment review than just outside here in the Walt Disney Theatre. In terms of entertainment on the ship, this place has been a real highlight for me. The Walt Disney Theatre. We've had headline theatre shows from Broadway's Beauty and the Beast to the Golden Mickeys. We've also had some fantastic entertainers who've been on shows like America's Got Talent, and Hen and Tenor. It's been really well organised. The theatre's been really easy to get into. It's a lovely theatre. If you'll see on my ship tour that I'm doing, you get a good view of that, and on some of the other vlogs as well if you check in. Absolutely fantastic. The cruise director is Anthony, who's done an amazing job with his team in putting all of that together. There's a lot of trivia on the ship, so if you like trivia, and especially if you're a Disney anorak, you're going to absolutely love that. I'm not a trivia buff myself, but there's loads of that going on. Seems pretty popular with the cruise passengers as well. There is a sports court, which you can probably see just in the background up here. It isn't open that much, actually. I'm kind of half a day for some reason, but my son's been up there a bit as well, so he's enjoyed that. There's table tennis and football, or foosball as they call it. There's a huge mini golf area too. We've also had an a cappella band in the theatre. That was something different. We've had a contortionist stroke kind of comedy professional there as well. That's been really good. There's so much to do, and if that doesn't take your fancy, then you've got funnel vision behind me here on the other side of the funnel, which is playing Disney films all day long, every day. So you could just sit and watch a Disney film all day in the beautiful sunshine here near to the Bahamas where we are now. So entertainment's a massive big score for me. You're not going to get bored on a Disney ship. And of course, I can't forget that there are characters everywhere. There's Goofy, there's Pluto, there's Max, there's all the princesses. I lose track. There's Donald, there's Daisy. You know, they're everywhere. They're, particularly in the morning and in the evenings, it's a really relaxed queue. Never gets too big. And they spend quite a bit of time with you. They'll sign autographs. It's great fun. And they just suddenly appear around the ship as well. So as well as the organized meets, Pluto bumped into my son on deck 5 just a couple of days ago and gave him a mission to do. So that was crazy. So absolutely, we've enjoyed all of the entertainment on ship. It's been a big hit. And then I come to the food. The food on the ship has been really good. There are three main dining restaurants. So there's the Animator's Palace, where they have a special show going on during dinner. There is the Royal Palace, and there is the beautiful Enchanted Garden as well. And you rotate through these three main dining rooms every night of your cruise. So you do all three in a row, and then you start again. But what's really unique is your waiting team, including the restaurant manager for the whole area, they follow you around every evening, so they stay with you. And in our case, we've had a fantastic service from Simona, the Italian restaurant manager, and his team. Nicola and Raina, our waiting team, have been absolutely brilliant, and I haven't heard anything bad from other people as well. They'll do anything for you. They'll do some things off menu if you ask them in advance. They'll try and adjust items for you as best they can as well. Really, really fantastic. You'll see them in a couple of my other vlogs on the ship if you check out the channel and see them in action. And they've been super friendly, and they've made a huge difference to us. The main dining is excellent. In the mornings, I've mainly been to the Royal Palace for the kind of what we call the formal breakfast, which is the table service breakfast. All the staff down there have been excellent as well. The breakfast has been really good. But we've been to Cabanas for a couple of breakfasts and enjoyed that too. It's a little cramped in there. It is quite big. It's deceptive. It's bigger than you think when you first look at it. The tables are a little closer together than we're used to, but it's very well prepared, and we've really enjoyed that too. So All in all, food's been an excellent experience. They do have some additional dining options in Rennie and Palo up on the top deck. They're beautiful restaurants. You see them on my ship tour, and that's an additional dining option. And they are really, really popular, so you do need to book them in advance. They have a little Vanellope's ice cream parlor as well, which is also an additional option, although they do include ice cream, cone ice cream from the machine on the ship, unlimited, and sodas as well. That's all part of your Disney package. Is the V8 Cafe. And the V8 Cafe does hot dogs, burgers, all your kind of fast food, chicken burgers, also does some salad items. A really popular taco bar that's brand new to the Disney Dream. And they do taco bowls, they do chicken and beef tacos, vegetarian tacos. That's the only thing you really have to queue a fair bit for, because it's been so popular on the ship. They also do sandwiches there too, pizza as well, which is really nice pizza. For those of you from the UK, it's a bit like Pizza Express type pizza, if that suits you, but that's been really good too. So overall, the dining experience has been brilliant. There's two set services, I must mention, in the evening. You can either have 6:15 or 8:30 here on the Disney Dream. And that's important if you're wanting to go to the theatre every night, because the theatre, obviously, if you go at 6:15, you'll go to the later 8:30 show. And if you go to the 8:30, you'll go like we do for dinner, you will go to the earlier 6:15 show. So yeah, that's kind of how that works. So again, the dining experience has been absolutely superb for us. Now that then links into the service and the crew of the ship. And again, they've been absolutely outstanding. And this for me goes back to when we very first started cruising in 2011 on the P&O Aurora, when the staff couldn't do enough for you. And that's what it's like here on the Disney cruise ship. They really can't do enough for you. It's just been sensational all across the ship. And guest services, you know, I think quite a few people moan a bit about guest services on the cruise ships, but on Disney, they always have about 7 or 8 staff waiting for you. You get served really quickly, and they are super helpful. Again, the waiting staff, the guest services, and every night in the atrium, the officers are out in force, including the captain many nights. So we've met him a few times. Great photo opportunities. There's normally 7 or 8 of the officers in the atrium talking to the staff. There's a really great connection there. And I think that kind of feeds through to the whole atmosphere and how the general demeanor is of the crew as well. It seems a really happy ship, and that makes for happy passengers. Captain Zonomir, you've done an amazing job on this cruise. Your whole team have been fantastic. So again, that's been top notch. Now, in terms of the port adventures, they obviously, this is a transatlantic cruise, so they're fairly limited. We went to Lisbon, which is an absolutely fantastic port. Absolutely loved it there. Vigo was a nice port as well. The Azores was very quiet, but we had a massive walk around. Again, you can check these out on my other vlogs. And we're going tomorrow to Lighthouse Point at Lookout Key, which is Disney's private resort in the Bahamas. We're really excited about that. I'm putting out a separate vlog on our day there. So if you're not subscribed, take a chance to hit the subscribe button, and you won't miss any of that. And we also have, of course, another 25 days in Florida coming up, where we're heading up to Orlando on the Brightline train. That's a new experience for us. So we'll be showing all of that on the channel. Of course, we'll be visiting the parks. We've got some food vlogs coming up, and we're meeting some people up in Orlando for some fun as well. It should be interesting. So there's a lot of great things happening. So click subscribe if you get the chance. Always appreciate our new subscribers. Now, Wi-Fi on the ship, it's a Starlink system. It is the Starlink system that Princess and P&O, for example, have also adopted. I think most of the cruise ships are. It's pretty decent for normal internet in terms of uploading videos, downloading videos. It's a bit slow. For a 30-minute video, it did take me 6 hours to get that up. But if you're just doing standard internet stuff, browsing the internet, talking to family, then that's not a problem at all. And here's a good one for you. You don't have to pay for the internet to use WhatsApp. So without the internet, you can use WhatsApp to message your family around the ship, but also back home as well. So WhatsApp works without an internet package. So you don't have to get that if it's just messaging that you want to do on the Disney Dream. So that's been fantastic for us in terms of communicating back home and on the ship as well. There's also an onboard Disney chat too, which can be used particularly for the kids to chat with their friends who they meet in their kids clubs. And speaking of the kids clubs, my daughter's gone, she's 14, she's gone to the kids club, absolutely loved it, made a lot of friends, there's so much going on down there. Son, who's in the 10 to 14 group, he hasn't done so much, didn't like it quite so much. Personally, don't think he gave it much of a chance, but hey, the younger children go to the Oceania Club and wow. Again, I've got a separate vlog on this because it is so cool. So it's for the 3 to 10 year olds. It's got a Millennium Falcon in there. It's got a interactive Spider-Man room. It's got Andy's Toy Story room. It's got an interactive play floor plus Pixie Hollow Wood. And you get the chance to go in for open houses. So we were able to go in for an hour and actually play ourselves. So they have these open houses for the youth activities. And sometimes they even have adults only as well. So that was pretty cool. So big thumbs up, and the youth staff have also been excellent. Big, big marks for them too. Now I'm going to go slightly back and just mention, everything's really been quite positive about the Disney Dream. It certainly has been, but embarkation was a nightmare, a debacle. We were held up massively. There was a big pinch point at the port. It was chaotic outside of the terminal. Didn't seem to be any organisation, big thumbs down. But once we got in the terminal, it moved really smoothly, like everything else has done since we've been on this cruise. And that was at Southampton, because this is the westbound transatlantic crossing. If you're an adult on this cruise, you're also in for a real treat. If you're a Disney lover, obviously, but there are some a lot of adult areas, adult-only areas for you to sit in. There's an adult pool. Like a sanctuary area that you can go in, which is really, really peaceful. And unlike on most other ships I've been on, in fact, all of the ones I've been on, you can leave your kids in the kids clubs when you go ashore if you want to. It's not something we do, but people certainly do, and we met some people who did successfully as well. And there are adult bars in the evening. There's the 687 which has the football on, the pink champagne bar. There's so much going on up there. So you're going to absolutely love that. And I should just mention Preludes, which is by the theatre where you can get buckets of popcorn and chocolate bars and things like that for the shows as well to take in with you. You can get a popcorn bucket, like a Stitch themed one, for example. It's about $20, and then refills for the rest of the cruise are $2. And if you're heading on to Orlando, you can also use it in the parks as well. There's also a cheaper option, like a bucket with Disney themed popcorn bucket. And that's about $10 with refills for a couple of dollars. And again, you can use that in the parks to get refills as well if you're heading up there after your cruise. So that's really good too. This aqueduct ride up here, which is a tube slide, which you'd normally go around in pairs on. Sometimes they allow single riders. Goes around the top of the ship here on like a raft. Mrs. G has certainly enjoyed that, as has my son in particular, who's been on that quite a lot. When it's windy and bumpy, it sometimes isn't able for safety reasons to be on, but it is most of the time. And yeah, it's really, really popular. But we haven't had a queue, you don't have to queue very much for it, just a few minutes. You do have to get upstairs to get to it to get on. And when you're getting out, it can be a little bit of a challenge as well. But yeah, very, very enjoyable part of the ship. There's also a kids slide and the Mickey slide as well, which is a yellow kind of twirly slide, which kind of younger kids can use all the way up to age 14. So with one day to go, I'd say this, if you're going on the Disney Dream, you're going to be looked after by the most amazing crew. They're rebasing themselves in America's for a while now, where they'll be heading around the Caribbean. You're going to be looked after by an absolutely fantastic crew. The ship is beautiful. It's got 2 swimming pools for the kids, a really fantastic smaller one, the Mickey pool, and the Donald Duck one, which is a bit deeper. The Mickey one is really great if you've got small children. It's only about 1.5 feet, maybe 2 feet deep. And they have lifeguards on every pool all the time, which I've never seen. And they check the pools, I think every hour. They get everybody out for 10 minutes. They check the filters. They check the water to make sure that it's safe for everybody. It took me a while. I didn't actually work it out. I had to ask. But absolutely brilliant what they're doing there in looking after all of us on board. And they also have an adult pool. There's a whole adult area. And you can see the pools down here, guys. This is the Donald pool, slightly deeper pool here, and the Mickey pool at the other end. They are next to the big screen here, so it can get quite loud. And the Disney horn goes off during the day as well, which is also very loud. And I must mention also, in terms of the entertainment, the deck parties that they have, including on this cruise, 2 nights of fireworks. Normally they have one, but we have 2 firework nights at sea, massive party on deck, there's dancing up there as well. I absolutely love that. And they have the characters dancing. There's the colour spin party we had, and another party the characters had up on deck for the other firework night, where they're all dancing on stage. Again, I've got some more video of that on some of the other vlogs for this transatlantic cruise. So we are heading off tomorrow to Lookout Key, and then we are disembarking in Fort Lauderdale, but it's not over there. We are, as I say, spending another few weeks in Florida. So if you want to see all of that, just click the subscribe button, and there'll be some more vlogs coming out both on this cruise and the adventures over the next month in Florida as well. And we've got so much going on there. So from Maverick Hill, here on the Disney Dream, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks to all of our subscribers and our new viewers as well. Wherever you are in the world, I hope you're having a fantastic day. Carpe diem to you all. Live life to the full. And I'll see you on the next one. And by the way, it's Halloween today. And I think you hear the music in the background. But happy Halloween from the Disney Dream.